This is Manila's new front line. In a war, the police are not winning. A young boy is led out of the room by a social worker. He and his two sisters have been forced to act out live sex shows on camera by their mother. This home in a graveyard is where the children had to stay during a prolonged pandemic lockdown, with a parent desperate for cash.
It's absolutely tiny. So are you taking evidence now?
Yes, and she's the subject, the mother.
She's the mother?
Yeah.
So the mother's there still?
Yeah.
It's thought the mother was paid around $20 by a paedophile in Australia to exploit her own children. Police gather evidence, sex toys, smartphones. They're coming under pressure to deal with a drastic increase in these cases. There is some help for those who've gone through this trauma. At this children's home, they discuss the fairy tale Cinderella. 10-year-old Maria speaks up. She didn't give up. Even during hard times, she still has hope, she says. Just like us, even though our parents abused us, we should copy her. Maria and her brothers, John and Eric, were raped on camera by their mother, their aunt and uncle. The money their family made came from accounts in the UK and Europe. Today, all three are safe. And now 7-year-old Eric loves to sing. However, this is the emotional cost of that abuse. It may be distressing to hear, but this is their therapy, their release. Why me is the most common cry. Why your own flesh and blood?
Eventually, the pandemic contributed to the exploitation and abuse of children, since they are isolated and they thought that this is the only means of getting income and feeding their family. So these children are influenced by their families that this is just an easy job. They don't need to do anything. Just be naked in front of the video and they can earn something.
San, Chi, go!
And yet, these young people do have hope. They're taught ways to stay strong, coping mechanisms. They're encouraged to play, to be children again. While the adults who've spent decades fighting child exploitation here take on a bigger battle.
There has to be international law. This is the only way. And the UN should be involved in this and all national governments. They must cooperate together to restrict the passage of the child abuse material and the online streaming of the sexual abuse of children.
One arrest in one home. These officers are getting international help to trace abusers around the world. But charities believe more needs to be done to prevent millions of children being abused by those they should be able to trust. Laura Bicker, BBC News, Manila.